Janjana Shalakaya Chakshurmritam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Kadamahyam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yutapadakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahaganarabhunatam Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sakitam Shri Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahaganalalita Shri Vishakhanditam Nishya Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priya Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhyayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare Continue to discuss about the glory of Ranganath Kshetra. This is the place of holy pilgrimage of millions of people since many years. Why it is so special? We can see that this city visited by many acharyas, and as we already discussed, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also visited this place and spent 4 months. How many of you know how many times this city was attacked and destroyed and plundered? Anyone know? 3 times. Should I tell you the story how it was before we embark on the description of the life of Ramanuja Acharya? I can tell you a little bit history about this city so you can appreciate. Shiranganath Kshetra, Shirangam, was under attack of Mughals, of Muslim rulers, 3 times, major attack. One of the kings, his name was Ulu Khan. He once attacked the city with his general and he plundered the city as much as possible, and he murdered and massacred and killed 12,000 Vaishnavas here, just for your information. So it was not as peaceful place as you may think. Sometimes religious principles were under attack. And you can imagine 12,000 Vaishnavas were murdered and killed. And when this king with his army, he attacked and surrounded the city, he plundered and stolen everything from here, whatever possible. And just before he came, Vaishnavas, they were able to make the wall. They made the wall so they can cover the main deity of Sri Ranganath. They covered the deity so Muslim people could not know where is the deity. So they covered with the wall. They just covered with the wall. Cemented it, completely covered. So they were looking and looking and looking, where is the deity? They took the Utsavamurti of Lakshmi and they buried in the sand, Baluma. And then king still succeeded to find the Utsavamurti. When you're taking darshan, you can see Utsavamurti of Sri Ranganath. They stolen that murti and they took it to the Delhi. Delhi city, that time capital. Okay? Very briefly, I'm just mentioning so you can know. You know what happened? One lady, she dressed herself as a Muslim, Vaishnavi lady. She dressed herself perfectly as a Muslim and she was following the army because she wanted to know where they are taking the deity. And she was behaving in such a perfect way, so nobody even could detect that she is Sri Sampradaya Bhakta. And she followed the army until they reached Delhi. And even in Delhi, she was able to sneak as a spy to the king's palace as a Muslim. And she found that this deity was kept with the king. Later on, she will return back to Srirangam and she will inform the Brahmanas, Pujaris, where the main Ranganath deity. We'll come later in a few minutes to that. Meanwhile, King Ulu Khan, he left Srirangam, but he left behind one cruel general with all the army. Everybody can hear? So the general, he was continuing plunder and kill devotees. Killing means murdering, killing, massacre them. And his mission was to find the main deity of Sri Ranganath. He was looking and looking and looking for this deity. But as interesting as it is, history tells us that this general, he became attracted to very nice, beautiful lady Vaishnavi. He was a Muslim king, but he happened to be attracted to Sri Vaishnavi girl. She was very attractive and noticeable. So, by associating with her, one day he asked her, "Do you know where is Sri Ranganath deity?" And she told him, "Yes, I know. Come, I'll show you." And as it usually goes, men trust the woman, especially beautiful one, and those who are of demoniac nature, they completely trust in what they say. You can see like Mohini Murti cheated all the asuras. So this general, he was following this lady and she was taking him to the tallest Gopuram. She took him to the Gopuram, you know, this pyramid. And when they climbed to the Gopuram, he asked, "So where is your lord? Where is the deity?" And she pointed that was the deity of Vishnu there. And she said, "See, this is my lord." And this general was just looking and looking. "Where?" "See, here it is. He is the lord of my heart, Lord Sri Ranganath." And while he was looking, and they were already on the top of Gopuram, on the top peak Gopuram, when this general was looking, trying to find out, she just pushed him down. And this guy was crashed dead. And he died. And then she was thinking, "Now what? I killed the man in the temple. Now I became very sinful. Now I have to give up my life because it's useless. I became very sinful." So she herself From the same place, she jumped. And when she jumped, when she landed to the ground, not even one scratch was on her body. She didn't get any fracture. Her body was completely untouched. She was completely saved. Not even one single sign of injury. Because Lord Sri Ranganath became very pleased with her. In fact, Pujari told her, Lord Ranganath calling you. He wants to give you blessings. Because Krishna became so happy and pleased with her that she killed such a tyrant, such a murderer general. Because if she would not kill him, he will continue to kill thousands of Vaishnavas. And you know how devotees are very dear to Krishna. See, my dear devotees, we are sitting in the very historical place. It's not just fairy tale, we are trying to entertain you. This is the history. Hundreds of years of history. You can see and see on the walls. So many signatures, so many names written in the languages far, far from Tamil and different languages. Today, thousands of sannyasis came of Shri Sampradaya. Even governor of this Pradesh came. Because they are celebrating 1,000 years. 1,000 years of appearance of Ramanujacharya. Today, 1017, and now we have 2016. So it is like 1,000 years. It's quite an anniversary, isn't it? So great celebration, and this city still as it is, to facilitate devotees, to enhance their bhakti and faith. And today, I wanted to talk with you and share with you the incredible spirit which was imbibed by Srila Prabhupada. The same principle he taught all of us. And he was able to take the teachings of Ramanujacharya, which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu included actually. He included, as we already discussed with you, in the teachings of Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. Those two principles he took from Sri Sampradaya were pure, unalloyed, uncontaminated by karma and jnana in yoga, devotional service. Pure, uncontaminated, unalloyed, Prabhupada used to say. Unmixed, no desire of jnana and karma. Jnana karma anavritam anukulyena krishnanu shiranam bhaktiruttama. Complete pure. Only for the happiness and satisfaction of Lord Vishnu, Krishna. And second principle is selfless service to Vaishnavas. These two principles were held as a sacred motto, sacred mission of by Sri Ramanujacharya. And he actually lived, and his life was manifestation of these two principles. He lived through these principles. By his life he was preaching these principles. And his disciples, they were able to imbibe these principles to their blood, to their marrow, to their nook of the heart. They accepted these principles from Ramanujacharya. And we will discuss today some incidents from Ramanujacharya's life as well as from his disciples, which is great inspiration for me personally and for thousands of people in history. Very encouraging. That is the spirit of selfless service. So this is a Kshetra, Ranganath Kshetra. This is the principle of selfless service. So when that lady, she came to Shiranganath, who pushed this general. Shiranganath, he wanted to give her darshan and blessings. He said, ask me anything you want. I am pleased with you for your wonderful service of killing this general. She said, my dear Lord, I don't want anything. Really. But if you really want to bless me, I wish. So after my departure from this world, I wish my body to be burned by the fire from your kitchen. The same fire which they cooking food for you. By that fire, I want to be burned, my body. Till now the day. All dynasty of that lady, all the family and lineage, all members of the family of the dynasty coming from that lady are actually cremated with the fire from the kitchen of Shiranganath. So she was, that honor was given to her. Another lady, she dressed herself in Muslim dress and she went and she found out that Utsav Murthy of Shiranganath was kept in the king's palace. And she came back to the brahmanas, and few brahmanas they were hiding, few priests they were hiding. And when she informed them that I found Shiranganath, I'll take you there. So these brahmanas, they dressed themselves as a singers, beautifully singing bhajans. They went to Delhi and they started to glorify the king with wonderful songs and bhajans. So much so that this Muslim king became so pleased with them. Then he asked them, what do you want me to give you? What reward do you want? I can give you whatever you want. So they asked him for this Utsav deity of Shiranganath. And he gave them. He gave. So they took the deity and started to rush back to Shirangam. But interesting enough, that the daughter of the king, she fell in love with the deity. And she told to the father, I want that deity back. You have to give it back to me. So while they were on the way, king immediately sent the army to trace and catch these people. So to take the deity back. So these brahmanas, they had to hide themselves. They were running here and there, and they were hiding. And they were afraid to come back to Shirangam, because it was unsafe for them, for the deity. So they were, in meanwhile, 70 years passed. Nearly 70 years passed. After 70 years, it was no danger anymore in Shirangam Kshetra. So they came back. When they came back, they brought the deity. Meanwhile, the priests here, they thought that the deity disappeared. What to do? We need some Utsav deity. So they made new Utsav deity, exactly like previous one. So now, here we are, few guys, old people coming, bringing one murti and saying, this is the original one. And they priests in the temple, those who were already next generation, they didn't know anything about it. Forget it, guys. Who are you here? Get out from here. We have our deities. They were claiming that this is original deity. And these people, they said, old pujaris, no, this is original Shiranganath. So now they were in dilemma. What to do now? So, and there is no witnesses, because by that time most of the old people, they died. There were only two people, very, very old, those who still surviving from those days. One of them was Dhobi, washerman. And he was so old and he almost became blind. He could not see anything. So they came to him and asked him, which deity is the real one? So this Dhobi, he said, well, actually, I am Shudra. I am not allowed to do puja to the deity, so I really... By the way, I cannot see also. I am blind already. How I can tell you? But, he said, when deities were there, those days, I was given the service of washing their cloth. And when I was washing the cloth of the deities, I used to give this cloth to the pujaris, and the water from that cloth I used to drink. So if I'll do one thing, if I'll wash the dress of these deities both, and after drinking the water, by smell I can tell you which deity is right, which is wrong. That I can tell you. Every one of you have experience, right? I do have experience in my life also. Because as human beings, they also have special smell. I remember when I was very small boy, my father used to work very hard, very hard. And that time he was my deity, practically. My mother was working, she was like bank manager, she was from morning to evening, hardly I could see her. And most of the time my father was spending with me. He used to take me to kindergarten, take me from there. So I was best friends with my father. And sometimes my father had to work very late, so I happened to be alone at home. I used to sit alone. And my father used to tell me, don't worry, you should be strong like kshatriya, like soldier. You should not be worried at all. And I was just small kid, 5 years old. Okay, papa, okay. I was small baby. And though I was smiling, inside I was shivering all along, night time, I am alone. They had to come to the second shift at night. I used to take one small plastic machine gun. Brum, 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 AK-47 plastic. And some bulb was here. Brum, brum, brum. And I used to take the sweater of my father. You know sweater? The woolen sweater of my father. And I used to tie it around myself. And the smell of the body of my father. I used to close my eyes and I used to think, my father is with me. My father, by smelling the sweater, I used to immediately understand, yes, this belongs to my father. So that was giving me such a sense of security and feeling that you are actually not separated from your object of affection. That Dhobi, he said, I can understand the real deity by the smell and by the taste of the water from the cloth. And then pujaris, they wash their dress of the deities, or those who were at the present moment, and this Dhobi drank the water and said, this is not my Swami, this is not my Lord. And then these old people, those who came 70 years later, they washed their clothes of this original deity. And as soon as that Dhobi wala, he drank the water of the, yes, this is the original Ranganath. Where is he? Where is my Lord of my life? And immediately everybody had to accept that this is the truth. And they established original one to the main altar. So we can see in the history of Vaishnava tradition, Sri Sampradaya, devotees were selfless and completely surrendered without any reservation. We're going to discuss more and more about that when we will be talking about the life of Ramanujacharya. Where did we stop last time? Where did we stop last time? Yadav Prakash? Yes. He came back with Hunter and his wife, who were no one but Lakshmi Narayan. Right? They showed him the way, shortcut. And they brought him back to Kanchipuram. He came and informed. He informed his mother and he informed his wife, Rakshakambal, and his guru, Kanchipurna. So it was big festival that time. But then, after some time, Yadav Prakash was his disciples. They returned back. And to their amazement, they found Ramanuja. Actually, they came to the mother and said, "Oh, so sorry, so sorry. Your son didn't come." And then here, Ramanuja coming out. "What are you doing here?" "Oh, you know, this is, I lost in the forest." So they make up a story. And they decided that real fact should not be exposed. Ramanuja, his mother, wife and guru, they decided to keep this fact secret, as if Ramanuja Acharya doesn't know anything. And Govinda also didn't come. So then they ask him, mother ask Yadav Prakash, "Where is Govinda?" And they said that Govinda, when they came to Benares and then they went to those areas, he became attracted by the beauty of Lord Shiva. And he decided to dedicate his life as a pujari to Lord Shiva. And he left and remained there. He became great pujari there. Therefore, he decided not to come back. So his mother also, Govinda's mother, became happy. "Okay, he is a spiritual person. I am very happy." In fact, she went later on to visit her son and she became very happy. Meanwhile, Ramanuja Acharya decided to rejoin the school. When he rejoined the school, so everything was going on as usually, as Ramanuja Acharya doesn't know anything. One day, when they were walking in Kanchipuram, and Yadav Prakash, who happened to be great Mayavadi impersonalist, he was walking with Ramanuja Acharya with his hand on his shoulders. And it happened that the same day, Yamuna Acharya, very famous Yamuna, Alabandar, he came from Srirangam and he also was walking there. And from distance, he saw Ramanuja Acharya. He saw Ramanuja Acharya and he, by seeing his effulgence, by his beauty and innocence, he really wanted to come and embrace this boy, Yamuna Acharya. That time Yamuna Acharya was very old already, nearly 100 years old. And but he saw that this Yadav Prakash, great Mayavadi, and Yamanuja Acharya really didn't want to mix with his Mayavadis. He simply lamented. He lamented, "Oh, how come this nice boy?" Because by that time, Ramanuja Acharya already wrote his commentaries to very famous statements of Shastra. And Yamuna Acharya already read those commentaries and he really, really loved those commentaries. He understood that this is great Vaishnava. How come he come and trap with all these impersonal rascals? like yellow prakash. Yamunacharya immediately could understand these rascals. Because Mayavadis, they always saying there is no God, God is formless, there is no form, there is no roop, or God may be something different. You can worship anything you want. So Vyuta, usually they're worshipping five murtis, Durga, Ganesh, you know, Itali. Or then you choose whatever you like and worship. Because their philosophy, if you worship murti, it's like bridge to Brahman. All these murtis coming from void. Ultimately, you have to throw all these murtis because everything, aham brahmasmi, everything is same. And even Srila Prabhupada said, this is very, very dangerous philosophy. You can see, everywhere in India, this is a very, very core heart disease. Honestly, you go to Nepal, 99% people believe Om Shanti, right? We have many organizations, very spotless white organization who says that Atma is sitting here and there is only light only at the end. Nothing is there, only light. Very dangerous, very dangerous. And Shastra says, it's so misguiding because externally looks like very nice, very religious. They're also speaking on Bhagavad Gita. They're giving courses, even arts of living and everything, seminars. But people are mass. They're totally misguided. And at the end, they're going to void energy only. And they're stuck there forever. They don't understand that behind this Shakti, energy, covered beautiful form of Supreme Personality of Godhead.